Alrighty, I dug this out of storage today. This is a Sylvania Exponent 440 portable. It's a portable, this thing weighs a ton. Portable stereo phonograph. This is probably the highest quality portable stereo phonograph that was ever marketed. In my opinion, from what I've seen, I mean they had some other good sets, you know, but this thing really, really was excellent quality. And we'll get a quick overview. I don't have any auxiliary lighting, so I'm hoping this comes out. We have three switches on the front panel: auxiliary input, phonograph, stereo mono, and automatic, which turns on and off with the record changer, or manual on, which keeps the power on, which of course you'd need if you were using auxiliary, if you're piping a tape player through it or something. Got balance, loudness, treble and bass, a blue pilot lamp, and here we have our power cord input, speaker output, stereo headphone quarter inch jack, and your auxiliary input. Oh yeah, forgot to show the original vinyl zippered case with a metal zipper holding all of the patch cords and stuff. Let's see if this thing will open up. Alright. So our speaker cords. Here's our AC cord. There's a warning label in here. Warning. Do not replace cord case in storage area during operation of this instrument. Blocking the ventilation slots will cause overheating of the amplifier. Manual on. There's our pilot light. So that's all working all right. Feedback through the right channel. We do have a little grounding issue somewhere, maybe on one of these pots. Well, let's see. Let's get the spindle out, put that towards the front. And we'll get a record. I want to have here right now. Take the lock off. Set it to 45. Looks like this could use some grease. Alright. Oh, this thing also has I believe this is a magnetic cartridge on here. Okay, so the automatic function isn't working. Let's get the record down there. Looks like the damping mechanism is a little dried up too. Job. You see, we got this pressure feeding back here. See, we got problems with the right channel. If I put it to mono, it cuts in. And if you notice, I'll turn this up so you can hear it. Touch any metal part on the case, and you can hear it. That's interesting. Alright. By the way, it's on the bottom of the unit, which you can't see, but this is an Exponent model 440-2. So, I'll do a little bit more research on that and try to find out and put in the description the particulars of when that was marketed. They marketed several different styles of Exponent stereos over the years. I've actually got one that's more of the lathe, that's more of a horizontally oriented unit. It kind of lays flat. Caution. Hazardous energy. This enclosure contains no used or serviceable parts. Do not attempt to service for repair. Call authorized Sylvania serviceman. Well, tell me where the authorized Sylvania serviceman is around these days. We'll think about it. Show you what we're looking at. There's a running serial number sticker. Yeah, back in here, they also have one on the bottom. Looks like we have a connector here. Probably to disconnect power down to the turntable. I'm guessing these might be the wires coming down from the turntable. The transistors. You can see on the back to the control panel, which I guess if I undid these screws, maybe I could tilt this out. So hang on. Alright, so a quick look inside. What we can see so far, what in the world is that little pin doing there? Well, anyhow, I guess we'll have to unplug that. See some kind of service tag inside of there, some kind of advisory tag from Sylvania. Alrighty, well, after you undo the four screws that are underneath here, quarter inch, and I just noticed, you got these little two pieces of elastic here. That must have been for where to put the little bag with all of the wires and all. But after you undo those, then the whole panel here starts to pull out from the front. So, right behind the panel here, this is where, this looks like the leads from the phonograph, where they come up to the amplifier, and this will have to be disconnected. There we go. Never grab it by the wire and try to pull out one of these things. There we go. Even though it don't give you a lot to work with. I don't know what's on camera. Even though you don't really have a lot to work with and grab onto there, always try to grab it by the body. Get that undone. See if we can nudge this one along. Yeah. Alright, so we got those disconnected. The connector here, well, it might be anything to sort of pull apart. This ought to just pull right out. Yep, that was easy enough. Alrighty. There we go, with that disconnected. Go ahead and Take the amplifier out. All right. Now we can have a better look at this sucker here. Alright, so we can see there's switches back here that we'll check. There's the input panel, our output transformers, this printed circuit board, nice size power transformer. We'll turn her over. Have to get the chicken wire off of here. I was curious to see what these tags are. Let's see. Important. Read completely before servicing. Be sure all test equipment is free from leakage or isolated from a power line when servicing hot chassis. Blah blah blah. Never use speaker systems less than 3 ohms total impedance per channel. Blah 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 blah. And what's this little tag here? Huh, look at that. That is, yeah, it's gonna focus. Transistor layout for the chassis. I'm surprised this piece of paper is still in one piece after all these years. How do you like that? I thought I'd show this. I was just looking for information on these, and I came across this ad out of a newspaper from April of 67. Exponent 440. The ultimate in component portable stereophonic high fidelity system by Sylvania. 40 watt. What does it say? 40 watt IHF, 50 watt EIA, 80 watts peak power. So it is a Pickering magnetic cartridge, blah blah blah. Value priced at $209.95. And you can choose from our wide selection of Sylvania products from $59.95 to $1,950. Who knows what that would have been, but yep, $210. I did find some capacitors in there date coded early part of 1966. So, alright, so here we are back on the Exponent 442. And I had Shango 066 sent me a copy of the schematic for this thing, and I was studying it, and I said, well, I'm going to test these caps here, and blah, blah, blah. And I said, you know, I said, let me, I'm really not set up, you know, I'm back in the old workshop, which is gone now. Everything's down the street, but said, let me see. You know, I dragged out this cassette player, plugged it in the auxiliary. Now, we'll turn it over to auxiliary, on, stereo. And let's see what we got as far as, let's see, this tape, the pad fell out of this tape, but just wanted to make some noise, so let's see. This tape. Well, son of a gun. Well, look at that. Distortion. pressure seems pretty even. So that's through the auxiliary input. Let's turn down the output on the tape deck. And let's switch the cassette deck over to the phono inputs. Well, no distortion. No, it's hard to hear, but oh well. Of course it's hard to hear. I guess we ought to switch it over to phonograph again. So, what does this tell us? This tells us that number one, I'll have to get back to work on the stupid tape deck one day, and the tape ain't worth a crap. But this also tells us that there's nothing wrong with the amplifier for this Sylvania. So the whole grounding issue has to be back in the turntable. Somewhere in the tone arm wiring. Somewhere from this jack back down to the changer. So I guess I can go ahead and put the amp back in the machine. Because we really don't have an issue with the amp. So, stay tuned for the next part. Well, check this out. I put the thing back together and turn on the record player. Oh, where's the hum and distortion? So, let's see if I can get this thing to play a little bit of the record again.
Right, I'm sad and blue, cause I can't do the boogaloo. I'm lost, can't do my thing, that's why I sing. Gimme that thing.
So now all we gotta do is get the turntable freed up. I guess back in the wires going to the amp, back in them cables somewhere, the ones coming out from the phonograph, something was crossed or something. Cause now I got no problem. So this is fixed it and didn't even know it. So this was kind of a strange one, you know. But the good news is she's fixed. Don't really hear anything out of the filter caps. And, what quality they put into these knobs. You're gonna find nothing like that today. But anyhow. Yep. So, she is operational. Free up the turntable and we're ready to go. So, a surprising ending for me to this video anyhow. And, didn't really need to diagnose a hell of a lot. But, that's how it happens sometimes. Sometimes you get lucky. Alright, so here we are all back together. And there's one little tip that I wanted to make. If I can get enough light here. Let's see. Remember how the tone arm was really, it's like sticking, almost as if there was a damper underneath. You know how some of them turntables, the dampened fluid gets thick or something like that. Well, it's not really what happens with these guards here. In the back. Alright, this screw on the side of the tone arm here. And they have an identical screw on the other side. This is where the whole assembly pivots. And believe it or not, they put a little dab of grease on the inside underneath there. And it's not a lot, but when it gets old and hardens, boy, it makes the tone arm stiff. And what you have to do is you have to take this screw out and then take out the one on the other side, which we're not going to be able to see too well right now. And once you do that, you can gently lift the whole tone arm up a little bit to get to all of that, clean it off, and then put a little dab of whatever kind of grease you use, just put a little dab underneath there, and then align it all back together, because you basically have the outer plastic cover, then you have the metal part that the arm's attached to, that's underneath the plastic cover, and then you have the base underneath. You know, line all that back together. You know, you just use a toothpick or something. Get it all lined up and put your screw in there carefully and put it back together. That cures the stiff tone arm up and down. Other than that, I didn't even have to disassemble this thing all the way. You know, as usual, the little trip lever on the cycle wheel was gummed up. That was preventing the automatic operation. And, I took that apart and re-lubed it. I repacked the spindle bearing. And, I really didn't have to do anything else to this one. Everything else was alright still. So, she's working pretty good now. And we'll grab a record here. Show a final demonstration. Let's see. Put her up to 45. Oh. Might need to adjust that set down a bit.
This should go on forever.
That's a worn out wreck. Let's see if I can find something in a little better shape. This thing has a 6 and a 3 in each speaker cabinet. Really sounds good. Something in stereo. Whoop! Well, that didn't work too well, did it? Uh-oh. The spindle popped up. I'll have to check that out. Wow, this was played with a bad needle. Here comes the big boss! Hey! Well, anyhow, this is drawing on way too long. So, see y'all later. The old Exponent 440-2, alive and kicking.